circular economy, waste and resource are actually very closely linked to each other. So how does nature do this? You get a cycle where someone's waste is actually someone else's product. So we went to Mars, not the planet, but the factory. They produce a lot of this stuff. This is the wastewater from Mars. So what did we do? This guy. So we put it in the reactor, and just like you and me, if we eat too much, we're gonna develop a fat layer. If you really look at what this bacterial sort of fat consists of and you extract it, that is actually a bioplastic. And if you're Mars and you're producing something that's a bioplastic, what better to produce from this than your wrappings for your paper?
6 years ago, I became a caregiver myself. My parents became ill, my mother had a brain stroke, my father had a brain cancer. Many people said to me, if you need some help from us, you should ask for it. But I didn't, because I was too shy for asking for help. Almost a year later, my wife was diagnosed with cancer. We just became mom and dad, and we had our own business. And on that moment, I decided to act different. I actively asked for help for my neighbors. I knocked on the door and I asked them to help us with small but very important jobs, like cleaning, cooking, be some company for my wife when I was not at home. And it was a great time, but it was also a great time for our neighbors, because they had the opportunity to get involved and they had the opportunity to help. And that's how the Bucket Line Foundation was formed.
Can you all stand up, please, just for a moment? By touching the earth once a day, you'll improve the health of all future generations. Would you do it? If so, please do it with me. Now, this may still feel like tree hugging, but really, it's down to earth. 3 years ago, I picked up my first piece of litter. And every time I picked up one piece of litter, I knew for certain that that piece of litter, that piece of plastic, wouldn't end up in the plastic soup. So this would benefit all future generations. And from all the litter I gathered, I made this huge piece to show that we humans are slowly plasticizing our world. A lot of people followed my example, and now they pick up one piece a day. They pick up this amount of plastic each year. Most people think that what they can do is just a drop in the ocean, but they forget that the ocean is made out of drops. We can make a sea change.